In the category environmental pollution. Next is sound pollution. Uncomfortable sound is called noise. It is responsible for sound pollution. Measurement of sound pollution. Sound pollution is measured from the intensity of sound pollution. The unit for measuring the intensity of sound pollution is decibel. It is represented by small d and capital B. Unit decibel has been named after the name of famous scientist Alexander Graham Bell. Now, intensity of sound produced from different sources. Source of sound and intensity of sound in decibel of intensity of sound produced from different sources is given in the table. The intensity of breathing sound is 10 decibel. The intensity of ticking of a wristwatch is 20 decibel. The intensity of normal conversation among people is between 35 to 60 decibel. The noise of employees in an office is between 60 to 80 decibel. Intensity of sound of a truck passing on the road is 90 decibel. If a person shouts, the intensity is 100 decibel. Noise of a motorbike intensity is 105 decibel. Noise of a siren in a factory intensity is between 150 to 160 decibel. Now, intensity of sound beyond a certain limit is quite harmful. Harmful effects of sound pollution. A man can tolerate a sound intensity of 80 decibel without any discomfort. Beyond this limit, there are many harmful effects on human health. Audiological effects. Sound pollution of 90 decibel produces constant resonating sound in ears. A sound of very high intensity and close to the eardrum may damage the eardrum and person becomes deaf permanently. Physiological effects. Sound pollution effects are eyesight, heart, respiratory system, liver, and mind. Sound pollution produces headache and irritation in skin, vomiting, giddiness, etc. Psychological effect. Sound pollution affects living beings, which change their act and behavior. Their behavior become irritating and they feel mentally disturbed. Other effects of sound pollution. Sound pollution disturbs us in our day-to-day activities. It disturbs conversation or lectures in the schools or colleges. It may also disturb sleep, which in turn will affect our normal health. In banks and offices, sound pollution reduces the working capacities of the employees. Not only human beings, sound pollution also leave their impact on animals and birds. Animals leave noisy places and build their nests at peaceful places. Noise makes animals dull and irritating. Now let's discuss the summary of effects of noise pollution on human health. A brief summary of effects of noise pollution on human health is as follows. If intensity of sound is 80 decibel, it produces irritating sensation in human beings. If intensity is 90 decibel, it reduces listening ability. If intensity is 95 decibel for a long time, it causes excessive irritation and excitation. Intensity 110 decibel causes stimulation or excitation of skin. If intensity is 120 decibel, then it is very difficult to bear it. There is painful feeling. If intensity is between 130 to 135 decibel, it starts creating nausea and vomiting in human beings. If intensity goes up to 140 decibel, there is pain in ears, chances of mental imbalance if prolonged exposure to noise pollution is there. If intensity is 150 decibel, burning sensation skin is caused. At a level of 160 decibel intensity, eardrum ruptures. If intensity is between 180 to 190 decibel, damage of ears and other body parts occurs in a very short time period.